Greetings, it's Eric Backer, New Zealand naturopath. Thanks for checking out my video. Today we're going to talk about Candida and weight gain. So the question is, can Candida cause weight gain? Well, it absolutely can. And I've dealt with this with patients now for many, many years, with people, you know, gaining weight with yeast kind of problems. So there are four primary ways in which Candida is linked with weight gain. So let's explore those four ways. One of them is basically a stressed out immune system, adrenal stress in particular. One of them is going to be sugar cravings. One of them is going to be toxins. Okay, so toxins that are produced by Candida in the gut. And the other one, just tiredness in general, you know, produced by Candida. So let's have a look at the first one, at immune stress, particularly adrenal immune stress. So many people with Candida, particularly chronic Candida, not only have Candida, they often have an imbalanced gut. They'll have bacterial imbalances. They'll have poor levels of beneficial bacteria. And often they suffer from adrenal problems. They're going to have adrenal fatigue. They're going to have stress. They're going to be making inappropriate decisions regarding their diet and lifestyle. They're going to have poor cortisol levels. I've spoken many times about the relationship with cortisol and Candida, particularly poor recovery. So when cortisol is elevated, it causes immune suppression. When cortisol is elevated, it basically puts you in a survival mode. And when, you know, we evolved, if you believe in evolution like I do, which to me is science and common sense, when we evolved, our bodies, you know, were designed that if we couldn't find food and we were stressed, it would lock fat down so we could burn that fat off, you know, in periods of low, you know, when low food was around. And this is what happens today with people. They get high stress, they get fat. And particularly with gut imbalances like Candida. So Candida can create stress for the person, and stress can create Candida for the person. So those things are very much linked up. So immune stress is very real, and particularly its relationship with weight gain and Candida. So that's number one. So let's take that one off the list. The other one is tiredness. The biggest prerequisite I see for really good health is energy. Energy is like a currency, okay? The body loves energy. Energy really allows us to think properly, to act properly, to feel great, and to have a currency that we can exchange for an amazing lifestyle. You've got to admit, if you've got poor energy levels, you can't function. Think about it like your mobile telephone, okay? If you've got an iPhone or one of these smartphones, people like to have their phone always high charge, 80, 90, 100%. Now, what about if your body walks around with 22%? When you want to do something, there's not enough power there really to execute what you want to do. And that results in fatigue, tiredness. And with tiredness comes low motivation. Poor ability to want to get off your bum to do things. And this is where weight gain comes from. Your metabolic function decreases. Your drive decreases. Motivation's down. So you sit on your butt. You don't want to do much. And what do? You eat. You watch The Simpsons on TV. You know, you make crazy decisions. You're sitting there in front of a computer all the time. Rest is rust. So if you're going to sit there, you're going to gain weight. Tiredness and fatigue induce poor activity equals weight gain. Easy to understand. It's common sense, isn't it? So there's tiredness. And again, the adrenals are linked with that. Get a lot of sleep. It's a big one. Sugar cravings. Craving sweet food. How many people don't crave sugar today? And then I get people saying to me, oh yeah, I'm okay, I'm just going to have some xylitol or erythritol or mannitol or one of those alcohol sugars. I'm going to be fine with those because they're zero calories. Well, you're in la-la land if you think that you can eat these fake sugars and get away with, you know, without paying the price. Many people who eat these fake sugars eventually want them all the time. I've seen this in diet sodas quite a lot too, that people often like to drink a couple of cans a day, you know, or you know, couple of big bottles of it. Watch out for fake sugars. Sugar definitely is linked with Candida. We know that. I mean, that's a given. It's a no-brainer. So people who have Candida often crave sugar. They love sugar. And we know that sugars contain calories that are dead. They just sit around your waistline, around your butt, you know, around your legs, under the arms. So sugar equals poor metabolic function. And it's one of the primary things that drives non-alcoholic fatty liver. It makes a fatty liver. It slows your metabolism down. It makes you fat. Sugar makes you fat. We know that. Sugar induces heart disease. Sugar pushes you into diabetes. Sugar shunts you into cancer eventually. It creates acidosis in the body. And people crave sugar when they've got candida. They crave sugar. They love it. Okay? Mary, I want that scone or muffin. Joe, I want that cold beer. Peter, I need that pizza. Get on the dial up now and get me that pizza. So when you've got candida, candida will be calling your name. And it likes to call your name after supper at night. You're sitting there watching your favorite program. What are you watching TV? I don't know what you guys out there watch. Could be one of those, you know, talent shows or something. Or, you know, many times I've heard patients tell me they have a good supper at night, but then they want something more. Okay? You're feeding yourself and you're feeding the gut. You're feeding yeast or bacteria. It's quite common. It can happen after lunch, but it commonly happens at night time. Or you're driving to the gas station and you're getting gas. Ah, there's a Hershey's bar. I might just quickly eat that. So when you're driving around and you're thinking of sweet things, it's like the alcoholic wants to have the drink at 5 or 6 o'clock because they feel entitled to it. Okay, they feel rewarded by it. Don't reward yourself with sugar. It's a trap. And a lot of companies know it. So where do they put all the candy bars when you go and buy the gas? Right in front of your face. Don't fall for it. Sugar cravings equals weight gain. Tiredness equals weight gain. Immune stress equals weight gain. The last one is toxins. Toxins produced by candida. So candida can produce up to 100 different types of toxins alone. I've talked previously about acetaldehyde. I've talked about gliotoxin. There are many different poisons that candida makes as part of its life cycle. Poisons that affect the liver function. Poisons that clog the body up. Poisons that induce mental fatigue, emotional fatigue, physical fatigue. Your liver needs to work well. If it gets sugar, it doesn't work well. If it gets alcohol, it doesn't work well. All the reasons why we don't want you to have these things in your diet. So candida toxins are an important part of slowing down the metabolism, of clogging up the liver. And the liver is the big fat burner. If you don't want to belong in the BBC, the big bum club, you need to have a well-functioning liver. Remember, all these foods we talked about affect liver function. Healthy, fresh vegetables, low sugar containing fruits we've spoken about, like avocados, for example, like berries, and then lean proteins. These things actually support liver function and aid detoxification, and also eventually will stop you craving sugars and you'll burn off the fat. Does it make sense? Makes sense to me. Thanks for tuning in.